You are in for a treat. I've been trying to get this brother here. He was at our show years ago, and he's so busy, and we finally got him tonight. Are you ready for your headliner? All right, from St. Louis, now here in LA. You've seen him on Who's Got Jokes, The Comic's Edge, and Juice TV Live. Please put your hands together for our headliner, Mr. Aaron Edwards Hall.
Give it up to DJ, I do whatever I feel like, man. Thank you, sir. Give it up for Mel and everybody you heard this far, man. This is an awesome show. This is a great show. I'm happy to be out here, had a ball coming up as well from LA. Took about 5 freeways, but I made it. Y'all some troopers. I saw all that smoke coming, I thought it was a rat. Like the rapture has happened in our carriage. Lord, only them. So I'm happy y'all came out, man. I'm celebrating a lot of things. Just had a birthday. Lee was in the house. So celebrating a lot, man. Lost about 25 pounds. Build up 25. I had to start cutting down. Yeah, man. I had to lose the weight. I got to the point I couldn't suck my stomach in no more. So some people been there. You know what I'm talking about. You try to suck your stomach in your shirt, be like, no, player, this is good. You don't think you forgot about that Big Mac and double cheeseburger you had the other day. I had to lose that. I lost some weight doing the insanity. Anybody ever seen that? You know what I'm saying? Yeah, when you're in your living room looking goofy, right? Yeah, it's, ain't the family move, but to get the job done. That's how I'm saying. My intentions were to lose 30 pounds, but I actually had to stop about 5 pounds short because I didn't like the way Sean T was talking to me. I didn't like his spirit, you know? Trying to work out like a man. He's talking about just keep doing it. Are you talking to me? I'm good. I don't want to see no grown man in that living room doing hip hop ass. I do not want to see you in your living room doing this. This is not the man, boy. He can slip with you too. He's like, turn around with you. Nah, I'm good, girl. I'm good. Just stay fat right here forever. For real, man. Celebrate a lot, man. Just made it, we heard 26 years of marriage, that's incredible, but I just celebrated 2 years of marriage. Yeah, who would make the top that? It's awesome, man, I'm celebrating 2 years of marriage. We also have a beautiful baby girl. Yeah, beautiful daughter, who also happens to be 2. So you do the math on that. Had to put a ring on it. I believe in being honest about my testimony. That's all. Because people can count. I'm trying to trick people. Yeah, I got married in March. I'm like, congratulations. Had a baby in July. Was she premature? Nope. Regular baby. That's what I had. It's real, man. Funny, man, we only 2 years in, and I am already understanding the concept of a family that prays together, stays together. Yeah. Absolutely. Family that prays together, stays together. But sometimes I got to sneak off and pray by myself. Yeah, I'm gonna be honest with you, there's still a little heathen left in it. You know what I'm saying? I was a heathen for 30 years, you know what I mean? It takes at least 5 years for your heathen to clear, you know what I mean? Well, I got to pray to myself. I got to pray before I do anything. You understand that? I can't go to the grocery store without a prayer. The Jezebels are in the grocery store. And you can identify them by the yoga pants they have on. Why? tempt me. Hey man, I gotta pray. I have to fast before I go to the mall. I fasted the whole day today just because I knew I was gonna have to walk through the mall again. Tell you, man, it's a cold day. But I thank God for my family though, because it's matured me. You know what I mean? It's made a man out of me, right? Because every decision I make, you know, it affects my family. Because I remember before I got married, I was the worst. I'm gonna be honest, I was one of the best, worst dudes you could ever meet. For real, I was a good dude. I mean, I loved the Lord. I did, but I was a heathen at the same time. I used to join all the groups in church, all of them. And then I would quit them all. Because I was in sin. But you don't know how hard it is to be on the prayer team. Somebody come up to you for prayer, they'd be like, brother, can you pray for me in the area of lust? And I was like, man, you too? He was like, huh? I was like, just lift your hands. I started praying for us. I said, Lord, my God, bless us. I'm in these streets, though. It's hard out here for all people. And this is the day that she knows she was wrong for wearing those apple bottom jeans. You see on high, you look down low. She blessed, Lord. She had a favor. By the time I opened my eyes, she was gone. I was like, oh. Because he got what he came for. Real, man. Cold game. But I'm learning. I'm learning a lot, man. And you know, we did it the wrong way, but we got it right. You know, God is a very forgiving guy. He's a gracious guy. I talk about it all my real life because I believe people won't come because they think you got to be perfect. That's just not how it works. He's forgiven us. But the thing about it, he won't just change your circumstance. Yeah, now we got to go through some things. You know what I'm saying? We used to be able to do whatever we wanted before that baby came. Whatever. Baby, let's go to the movies. Bam, we at the movies. Baby, let's go to the steakhouse. Bam, we at the finest restaurants. Now I'm in the grocery store making life decisions. You are not supposed to be in a food for less making life decisions. You know what I'm saying? I had to get the tuxedo cookies the other day. Oh, okay, so y'all living well out here in Ontario. Y'all eating Oreos out here in Ontario. I bought tuxedo cookies, just these milk-resistant cookies. But you can put in the milk for an hour and they won't crush. I had to suck on these cookies like a hog, man. Tell me, man, that's what my life is. It's being real. I can't fly the way I want. I'm a comedian, right? So I got miles. American first class, United first class. But now, if they ain't flying me out, I got a Southwest Airlines budget. Oh yeah, the ones laughing know what I'm talking about too. Yeah, because they be tricking you with the commercials. Yeah, your bags fly free. There's a reason your bags fly free. That's because you're going to stop in every city in the 10 radio. You're trying to go. You got a better chance taking the Greyhound to get where you going on time. For real. I went to St. Louis not too long ago to get to St. Louis from L.A. I flew from LAX in the Chicago Midway back to Spokane, Washington. Then into Norfolk, Virginia. Got all the planes. Been the night at a friend's house. I flew to Baltimore. Then into St. Louis. That is ridiculous. But for $49,
I'm gonna be on that flight.
With a peanut butter jelly sandwich and some tuxedo. For real, man.
On it.
It's a lot I can't do now that I'm married. Some of it's good stuff. No more Vegas. You know what I mean? Honestly, you know, when you're married, ain't no point in going to Vegas. You just feel like a mummy. You just be like, oh, I can't look. Oh. Jesus, why put yourself through that pain? But now that I'm married and sober mind, I realize the only fun part about Vegas is really the trip up there. You ever notice that? That's the only fun part of Vegas. You be in your car, just high five, and people are like, ah, we going to Vegas! The music's so loud, you're like, I got a feeling. Tonight's gonna be this is the best ride you ever been on. going down the 15, you start going down the hill and you can see the Vegas City Lights. That's like a roller coaster. You're like, ah, it's a party, it's a party, it's a party. This is the best ride you have ever been on. But that ride home is a little bit different. It's quiet in the car. You're in there, man, turn that music off. The whole goes down, it's hot in here. Start shouting out phrases like, all of it? Yeah, that's how I can tell who really had a ball in Vegas. You never came home and said, all of it? I spent everything, you understand that? I had to get money wired to me to get back home. I'm on the phone like, look here, bro, you got $49 I can borrow for tomorrow. Get back on this Southwest. Then to get back home, I flew back to Atlanta, then up to LaGuardia. This is the worst trip of my life. Telling you, man, it's different. You get married, you start learning different things. One thing that helps, I'm a very giving individual. I love to give. That's just how I am. And my wife, not so much. Right? So it helps us, right? So I don't give away everything. See, so now, like, I'm thinking about everything because we're on this budget, right? I love to give, but is it just me or the homeless out here on the West Coast extraordinarily talented? Is it just me or do they have gifts? I swear, if I see another sign with gift penmanship, I'm going to lose my mind. I don't get that. How you give up on life but not your good handwriting? I'm reading the sign the other day. The sign says, I bet you a dollar you'll read this sign. So I'm like, I bet you a dollar you'll read. Then I made a mistake and looked at him. He's like, come on, play out. You earned that dollar. I'm going to give it to you. You earned it. You have a job with them kind of smarts, man. For real. And if you don't run into the crafty dude, you run into the aggressive brother. You know, the guy, you're going to do something for him no matter what you plan on doing. Brother came up to me so aggressive, I had to do something for him. He said, hey, brother, give me $10 and slap it on me hard. I said, first of all, please do this again. What is that? Is that part of the 10? What is that? I didn't know what to do. $10 is a whole lot of money, right? He did it into my time money at this point. I can't give you more than the Lord, right? So what we did, I happened to see a subway. Now, I think I'm doing something. I take the guy in the subway, I tell the lady, I said, ma'am, if you could make him whatever sandwich he would like, I would greatly appreciate it. This brother turned out to be bougie. Oh yeah, you have not lived until you run into an uppity bum. You understand? You had the nerve to get mad at the girl for not wearing gloves on his sandwich. I said, you kidding me, sir? You live on Earth, man. That's it. There's nothing in front of that. Ain't no place. You live outside, sir. You serious? He had the nerve to look at me and say, you dang right, I'm serious. They got an A outside, but they get an F in here because they understand the ticket. He said, you don't get out of here. This is ridiculous. I'm telling you, man. It's crazy. But everything I do, like I said, I do everything for my family, right? It was tough, man, because when my daughter was born, I was on tour, and I wanted to, you know, stay in the struggle. Not because I really wanted to, but because in Hollywood, they make you feel bad for getting out and getting a second job, right? So for the longest, I was like, nope, I'm staying in the struggle. Until I found out nobody else was struggling but me. Because they all have jobs. They just lie about it. That's it. Right, you just find out in weird ways. I'd walk into the Sprint store, see one of my fellow comedians. You know, I walk in, hey, you working? You have a job? Try to downplay it, nah, it's just a little something I do from time to time. You know, whatever they call me, you know, win in Rome. I'm like, nah, win in Burbank, because that's where we at, man. You have a job? Nah, it's just a little something. Is that an employee of the month plaque on your desk? Let me get this straight. Not only do you have a job, but you're the best. So I had to get a job, man. So now I substitute teach. I'm a substitute teacher. Yeah. At prisons. Yeah, don't lose your enthusiasm. They need it. Only messed up part is the prison I teach at is right by Magic Mountain. A place of fun. You can smell the cotton candy as I'm going in. They can see their favorite rides and can't get to them. That's true. But I've learned, though, through this process to stop judging people. A lot of times we judge people immediately, right? Not knowing anything about them. But I found out, man, listen, if my father had given me a fifth of Hennessy and some cocaine at 12 years old, I would be in jail too, okay? There's a reason sometimes people are in jail. So the way I tell a good guy from a bad guy is by the way they talk to their wife on the phone. Oh yeah, because some of these dudes be smooth cussing their wife out. And I ain't tripping, he in jail. He's doing exactly what he's supposed to be doing. Right? Who I'm concerned about is who's this insecure lady on the other end that is taking this cuss out from a man who can't do nothing about it for 5 to 7 years. Not only is she taking this cuss out, this is a collect cuss out. She is paying for the disrespect by the man. Tell me, man, it's a cold game when you think about it. So that's why I cherish my family, everything about it. I wouldn't go back to the single life for anything, because it's just different. It's different out here, man. It's different. I told y'all, I'm actually from a town so small, the closest thing I have to claim is East St. Louis. Yeah, I hear the grumbles, okay? For those of y'all who haven't heard of East St. Louis, haven't heard of Compton? Pretty much heard of East St. Louis. The same, we just don't have palm trees, that's the only difference. Yeah. And so where I'm from, a woman is hard to get, but easy to please. Got that? Hard to get, but easy to please. Because it's easy to please a woman where I'm from. Case in point, I went home not too long ago, got a rental car. My buddy was like, hey, can you take my friend to her car? I was like, bet. She got my car and lost her mind. She was like, ooh, is this a Toyota? I was like, well, yes, it is. Henry, matter of fact, yes, it is. That would never happen out here. You understand? For a woman to get excited over a Corolla, I couldn't believe it. Ladies, I really believe you should have whatever you want in life. I believe that. You're a woman, you should have it. I really believe that. I do. But my only thing is, if you want something out of life, I feel like you ought to have something yourself. Is that fair? Right, yeah. You can't expect brothers to pull up in a Bentley and you pulled up in a Kia. Okay, that ain't good at that. Okay, y'all not ready for me, each other just yet. Y'all not equally yoked if you get my drift. This brother has blossoms, you still young to come. Can't do nothing to bring his credit score down. For real. Because I'll never forget, before I met my wife, I'll never forget this. It happened to me. A lady was pulling up in her car, so I tried to talk to her. I went up to her and I'm like, excuse me, lady, can I talk to you? She hit me with, hold up, wait a minute. I'm like, wow, first of all, what is all this about? It's awfully rude and I don't deserve it. What is this? She was like, unless you drive a Mercedes Benz, don't even talk to me. I was like, wow, like I didn't know what to say, but then I thought about it, and I said, wait a minute, sister, didn't I just see you pull up in an Oldsmobile? Did you just get out of an Oldsmobile? You can't be up in it with an Oldsmobile. That don't roll off your tongue quite right. That's a Prentice Supreme, you understand? That's a drive-by car. That's a car you see on the news with bullet holes in it and bombers. It's an Oldsmobile. And stop all the neck jerking, I hate this. I hope your neck is stuck just like this one day. I hope you got to go to work on a Monday morning, you're like, girl, what happened to you? Now that had an attitude over the weekend. Real, man. An Oldsmobile. A lot of things, man. A lot of different things that I don't get, right? Let me ask you a question. Where are the ladies in here that either want or have a good man? Where y'all at? Good. That's about 30% of the nation. Y'all don't even believe in a good man no more. Is that what it is? A good man is like a unicorn or reparations, huh? Some of you are sitting in here with the man and you did not clap. I don't understand. Y'all sitting here like, no. No, the man on stage said, no. You do not qualify. Fellas, you have to back me up on this one. Here's my favorite. I don't really believe y'all want a good man. Mm-hmm. See, ladies, you say you want a good man, but y'all don't want a true good man. I'm going to tell you how I know this. I was watching a film the other day called Black Dynamite. Right? Now, this is a 70s exploitation film, right? Now, on the film, the brother's trying to get some from the sister. So the sister tells the brother, you can't handle these cookies. Because if I give you the cookies, you ain't going to know what to do with the cookies. So the brother told the same mama, right? Because at the 70s, that meant shut up, right? And so you can either come or you can go. You can hit the sheets or you can hit the streets. Either way, go. Don't make me no never mind. I was like, what? If that ain't pimping, I don't know what is. I'm sorry. That was an incredible arrangement of words, right? But the next scene, the brother's getting exactly what he wanted. See, let's be honest, you don't want the nice guy. You don't want the true gentleman. You don't want the guy that comes up to you and says, excuse me, Miss Lady. Now, I don't mean any harm. I don't mean no harm. I've been watching you for about a half an hour, and you are just the most beautiful thing I've ever seen. If you wouldn't mind, my queen, may I have your phone number? Y'all tell that brother, absolutely not. I have a man. Y'all want somebody to come up to you like, say, mama. Before I get out of here, can I share something with y'all? Can I open up really? Okay. I'm gonna let y'all know, man, I made a mistake when I got married. I made a mistake. I see a lot of men in here. You guys look wise. So I don't think you made the same mistake I made. But I made a mistake when I first got married, sir. I said to myself, I said, I'm going to be the man of my household. See? When I was sincere, I said, I'm going to run my household. I found out that ain't how it works at all. In fact, number one, the baby runs the house. Because when she take a nap, everybody got to take a nap. Because God forbid, one of her favorite Mickey tunes come on, she will lose her mind. She could be mid-REM sleep and wake up in there, hot dog, 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 hot dog. That is the jam, you understand? That is the turn up for babies. That is Drake for babies. Look here. They run the house. But my wife, she's second in command. And she runs the house, but she thinks she's slick. She's more subtle than her. Yeah, see, my wife likes to use the baby to get all her frustrations out on me. My wife will find any reason to pick that baby up. My wife will be like, look at all this trash in the trash can. Boy, I wish Daddy would take the trash out. But Daddy's a little lazy. For real? All you had to do was say, take the trash out, and I would have done it. Really? My wife is something else. Before I came here, she don't like it when I leave her home with the baby. She picked that baby up. She said, Daddy's leaving us at home alone again. He's going out there to Ontario where all those Jezebels are with those yoga pants. I know he better not come home smelling like Bath and Body Works. Just the two of us. I was like, you singing? I said, you know what? Give me the baby. Give me the baby. Oh yeah, give me, it's my turn. Yeah, I said, well, maybe if mommy would get out of that worn out house robe sometimes. And actually do her hair and start saying she's keeping it in the natural just because she don't feel like doing it. Maybe Daddy will stay at home sometime. She was like, oh, give me the baby. Give me the baby. She was like, well, maybe if Daddy could afford to pay for mommy's hair consistently. Maybe mommy would actually get her hair done. I was like, oh, you have to give me the baby. Give me the baby. No, give me, no, it's my turn. You gonna keep the baby on my turn? I wanna see my daughter. Give me the baby. Long story short, we about to have another baby.